Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about the rules of IUPAC nomination for aromatic compounds, and now we are going to do the methods of preparation of the aromatic compound, that is benzene. So let us try that, how can we prepare benzene from different chemicals. So let us talk about that. So friends, now we are going to do the method of preparation of benzene, and the method of preparation of benzene includes three kind of process, and in which the first one is we could prepare it from acetylene. The second is we could prepare it from sodium benzoate, and the third is from. So from these chemicals we could easily prepare the benzene, but yes, this involves different kind of the process also that we are going to talk about. So starting with the first one, that is how can we prepare a benzene from acetylene. Let us talk about this one. So now we are going to talk about that, how can we prepare benzene from acetylene. So acetylene is nothing but ethyne that we know, and ethyne is the one which consists of carbon-carbon triple bond, and for which we have to, if we have to convert it into a benzene. So this is the reaction that we have did earlier also, that is in the chapter alkenes. So this is the reaction that we have did earlier also, that is in the chapter alkynes. And now we are going to do the same reaction, and let us elaborate this reaction, that what is the reaction occurring to. And in this case, let me introduce that because of acetylene are being used, and because of which the polymerization would take place, and this kind of process that has been involved in this reaction, so as to convert a acetylene into a higher molecular compound, that is benzene, is basically known as polymerization. And that's the reason that we could use three modes of acetylene in this case, that is we could write it in this way also, just as to represent that there are involvement of three basically acetylene groups or ethyne groups. So this all three acetylene or ethyl groups, they will combine in presence of, that is they will pass this acetylene gas. This is basically a gas that will be passed through, that is red hot iron tube. And we will provide a temperature of basically around somewhere around 847 Kelvin. So this is the temperature that we have to provide, and this kind of huge temperature that we are providing, and in which basically the polymerization will happen. And in that case, what will happen is this double bond or this triple bond will now convert it into a double bond. So because of which the pi electrons and the pi bonds, which are very loosely bonded or which can be easily broken. So therefore, in that case, this would be involved, in which the bond fission would take place in such a manner that we could see an alternate carbon-carbon single bond and double bond. So therefore, if this bond breaks, then the electron of the carbon will come over here. And if this bond breaks, again the electron of the carbon will come over here, making this to be formed in one bond here. So therefore, in this case, the process would go on in such a manner that we could get a cyclic ring. And we know that polymerization in terms of an alkyne, it can go to linear polymerization as well as cyclic polymerization. But in this case, and for a particular condition, this acetylene undergoes a cyclic polymerization so as to form, that is benzene, which is this is what benzene is, and we have prepared it from acetylene, obviously known as ethyne. So this is how we can prepare benzene from acetylene. So now let us move on to the another one, that is preparation of benzene from sodium benzoate. Sodium benzoate actually is a sodium salt of benzoic acid. And what is benzoic acid? Benzoic acid is the one that will be represented in this way, that is if this would have been over here, H would, a hydrogen atom would have been over here, then this would be called as that is benzoic acid. But since we are talking about sodium benzoate, that is the sodium salt of benzoic acid, so in this case we could write it as. So therefore, this is can be called as sodium salt of benzoic acid, or basically known as sodium benzoate. And for this, we have to convert this into basically benzene. So benzene is the one that should not contain basically this carbonyl group that we have. So that is the reason that we have to remove this carbonyl group, basically in the form of carbon dioxide. And the process where we have to remove a carbon dioxide, or where we can remove a carbon, is basically known as decarboxylation. So therefore, the process that has been involved in this case is decarboxylation process, and that's the reason for which we have to use some special reagents, and those reagents are, that is, we have to use a base, that is, the base is nothing but NaOH is what we have to use, and that also in presence of CaCO3. So therefore, we have to make the reaction in presence of CaCO3 as well as NaOH. So what will happen actually, because of which the decarboxylation will take place over here, and we could see that this sodium along with this carbon will be removed in such a manner that this H would remain here. Let me explain to you. That is, this Na and this Na, they will combine with each other, and again this oxygen along with this C double bond O and again oxygen atom, they will combine so as to form basically Na2CO3. So this is what it has been formed, and only the thing that is been remaining is a phenyl group that is with us and one hydrogen atom. So this phenyl group and hydrogen atom, when combined with each other, they will form basically, so this is how we could prepare benzene from that is sodium benzoate. By using NaOH and CaCO3, and we could say that by following a decarboxylation process. So this is how we could make or we could prepare benzene. So now let us prepare the benzene from different chemical, that is from phenol. So let us talk about that also. So now we are going to prepare benzene from phenol. And let me tell you again that phenol is basically the name that has been accepted by the IUPAC also. And in fact, in IUPAC also, we could call it as a phenol. So suppose we have to prepare benzene from phenol. So what we have to do is, as the phenol consists of basically hydroxyl group, that is OH group, and for which the only thing that we need is, we don't need the OH group, we need only benzyl, that is a phenyl, and this hydrogen atom, and we don't need this oxygen atom. So for which what we have to do is, we have to introduce is some reagent that would be able to remove the oxygen, or basically what I am saying is that would be able to do the reduction process, and that is the reason we are using zinc or zinc dust, and we will heat it. So what will happen is, this zinc will be able to remove this oxygen, as well as we would also say that since zinc has an oxidation state of +2 and oxygen is also having a oxidation state of -2, so that's the reason that zinc would be able to remove the oxygen atom in the form of, that is, ZnO. And the only thing that will be remaining with us is basically a phenyl ring and a hydrogen atom, making together to be called as phenol. So the overall process that has taken place over here is basically a reduction process where we have removed the oxygen atom, and that is the reason that how can we prepare a phenol for benzene. So this is a very easy steps that we have involved, and from which we have made or we have prepared benzene from using different chemicals, as well as the different processes that are also being involved in that. So that's all. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know that what are the different kind of methods that we could prepare a benzene. So share this video with the friends, and if you don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much.